And good day, viewers. Today we're going to talk a little bit about everything wrong with my 2022 Tesla Model S long range. So as of next week, she'll be, right now she's a month old. Had about 3 weeks and put all of 7 miles on it since driving it home from the dealership. So the first thing is had the usual missing parts that's been fixed. We also had some unusual missing parts, missing rivets, that's also been fixed. And there's a few more issues, which we'll get into shortly. Apart from missing parts, we seem to have a problem with whoever does the delivery in Teslas to just never miss an opportunity to damage the car coming off the car carrier. So this is probably the most significant thing. And perhaps a little hard to see here. But, you know, seriously, can you just not hit the bottom of the car? You know, it didn't help to have the car in insane mode when I picked it up and with the suspension on low. I mean, that's just nuts. Another problem we had was apparently if they're in a rush on the assembly line, if they don't put a fastener in correctly, it just falls on the floor. This one, they try to install this fastener here. I don't know if you can see it. Probably not. But they cross-threaded it, so that's okay. They just spun the nut right off the fender and let it hang out a half an inch. So I got in there with some vice grips and reseated it because I didn't want to have to deal with somebody replacing the fender. The outside of the car was clean, but inside the wheels, I pulled the wheels just full of dust and dirt like it's been sitting on a dusty lot for a month, but I knew that wasn't the case. We've got a little clear coat drip here on the driver's door. You know, that's really nice. And we've got some other funkiness going on over here, where the paint's bubbled, apparently. And not unusual, but the wonky charge port door. So this makes a funny noise, if I can get it to open. But apart from that, that'll be replaced next service visit. But this is very common for the charge port door to not be seated properly. We got a little issue here where really hard to see, but there's a deep scuff enough to actually heat up the thermoplastic ABS on the bumper, cause a deformation, and there's like a black streak there, I'm sure caused by delivery or some other such stuff. We've got more damage under the rear aero shield. Can't see it, but it's minor, but they managed to hit the ground of that as well, shave off a little plastic. The overall alignment of the panels is pretty good. No big issues there. So let's move on to the inside. So the infamous seat wrinkles. And the passenger seat's the worst, so you've got quite a few here. Matching pair over there. The carpet. Well, the car on the inside was filthy. Literally. My 7-year-old car, which hasn't been cleaned in about a month, was cleaner than this. Fuzz and debris and other stuff I won't talk about, just kind of gross. You can tell where people were working on the car, and I still haven't fully cleaned it, but basically just dust and debris. The glove box is full of lint that just keeps on shedding like a dog with mange. And over here we got a misalignment of the the mow and blow guys are coming. We'll try to finish up shortly. Trim misalignments, that's about the worst. Yoke worm, very minor. And a missing panel down here that was broken, so I took that panel out. And let's see what else. This is a common problem where on both sides of the passenger door you've got this weird deal where the gasket's not seated properly. And again, exterior panel fit and finish trim is pretty good. There were some blobs of sealant on the window, which I was able to scrape off with the razor blade. And also this is an issue. If they don't seat your seals properly and they get in the sun, they just kind of stay there. So I'm trying to straighten this out, but she's not happy, doesn't want to go back down again. Let's see what else. Pardon for noise in the background. Fortunately, the cubby lights all work. I had the yoke replaced because of a broken left steering knob. And I don't have any cooing noises. I don't have any buzzing in the yoke, and my cubby lights work. Another view of some seat wrinkles here. If you can see that. But and this panel here was up, not installed properly. A lot of panels were loose. Had to push them in place. This is missing a clip. And this is my favorite part. So, kind of inside outside. So, you think maybe they could have borrowed a brass drift instead of a steel hammer to bang this hinge? And also on the other side, you think maybe they could have done a little touch up here? When they moved this door over, they just kind of left it like this, you know, exposed primer. Don't know. I mean, honestly, I'm up in the air whether the quality on this car is better than my 7-year-old Model S 85D. I kind of don't think so. So I'm really debating what to do. Probably 90% certain it's going to be sold because it's a nice car. But it's not 50 grand nicer than what I have now. So anyway, if you're looking to get a Model S, Plaid, or Long Range in order, I think this is a really good build compared to others I've seen. So be aware, number one, you're going to have shipping damage. Make sure you catch that on your delivery. Number two, you're probably going to have a lot of interior issues that you can fix yourself. For instance, here's one I forgot. It's super easy to fix. Just dirt. In this case, I don't know if you can see it, but there's, you can't see it, but there's basically tape residue on the headrest. So be prepared for missing rivets and trim misaligned. Second thing is going to be seat wrinkles. You may or may not be able to live with that. And lastly, make sure you check every single feature, including stuff like the charge port. It's probably going to be misaligned. And you may have some controls that don't work, like my yoke. Good news is, get a new yoke, you get the hidden horn switch, which will be hopefully activated by a software update. Last two things, I can't tell if I have ANNR, active road noise reduction, no karaoke, and so who knows when that'll come, but that'll probably be somebody else's problem. So I hope you have found that informative. If you have any questions, or if you want to purchase this vehicle, it is for sale for what I paid for it. So that's all for today. Before tomorrow, guys, blow me away. So have a good one, folks.